Sorry we've been gone, but don't worry, we're back. Let's check out what's old.
Welcome to Over the Years. My name is Tim, and I love vintage items. I hunt for treasures and bring you the ultimate prizes of antiques, collectibles, and vintage decor. Join me, my Dukes, my girlfriend Josie, and other guests as we search for history.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. It's been a while since we've been in this corner to do a What Sold video, but today we're gonna start catching up. We're about a month behind on showing you guys what sold. I know these videos are very helpful in giving you guys different things to look for while you're outsourcing. So I'm gonna try and drop as many of these as possible in the next week to try and catch up to what's going on right now. Been super busy working on some big projects. I'm looking forward to dropping those projects soon as well. This is your first time here. My name is Tim. I'm a full-time reseller. I sell on 6 platforms, but I just kind of started adding a 7th. So I sell on eBay, Etsy, Mercari, Poshmark, Depop, Grailed, and I've really been pushing Facebook Marketplace lately. I've had a couple of big sales on there, and you'll start to see those in a couple of What Sold videos coming up soon. So today we are going to go through everything that sold from July 13th to July 19th. So without further ado, let me just go ahead and pull up the sales for everybody. And it is a nice versatile group of items, which is, if this is your first time here, you'll know that that is one of our big things. We like to try and be versatile. It really allows us to maximize our profits by selling all these different items across all the different platforms. Excuse me, my throat's a little scratchy today. All right, so we are going to start with eBay. So the first thing in this video that sold on eBay was this vintage Anchor Hawking 96 ounce pitcher. It's called the Roly Poly, and the color was forest green. It's definitely a mid-century modern vibe. Any of the Anchor Hawking forest green stuff can be popular. There are a lot of collectors out there. Not all of it is necessarily big ticket items. Although I got this at a yard sale for $3 and it sold for $39.99 plus shipping. So definitely one of those ones that you want to look out for. And you can see the detail in the handle. It had the ice lip on there as well. So it was a nice picture, and it was a big sucker too. Golf clubs. I've been really trying to push all these golf clubs that I've had sitting around. So they're starting to move slowly, but surely. There's a couple coming up in the new videos you'll see of golf clubs that sold like in the same day. So golf clubs are definitely hot. Shout out to my man Casey over at the Carolina Hustler. If you haven't subscribed to his channel, I'll make sure to put a link below. He is the man when it comes to golf clubs, but he sells everything. He has been killing it lately, so shout out to my man Casey. So this is a Callaway Steelhead X14 Sand Wedge. It was a right-handed club, graphite regular flex shaft, and it sold for $15.99 plus shipping. Next up was this. I actually had this for a while. I got it for like $2, and it was a universal translator. It was like a language dictionary. I think it had 10 different languages, and it was brand new, still in the box, and that sold for $23.99 plus shipping. And these are all eBay sales. This was a snapback hat. So if you guys haven't seen, we have a couple of live streams that are dedicated to hats. Shout out to my boy Cernok over at Cernok's Connection, and Calvin the Kelly Hustle. This is a vintage 90s South Mountain Fishing Game trucker hat snapback. I picked this up in my first big lots of hats. It was it had some roughness to it. Like, I had to reshape it and things like that. I had, like, three of this exact same hat. So I took an offer, and it sold for $10 plus shipping. But I was only $1.67 into it. So a nice return on that hat. This is another interesting toolkit. At first I thought I was going to get a lot more money for it. But I ended up still getting good money for it because it was in fabulous condition. It was a vintage Ohio art company. They are one of the bigger companies when it comes to like vintage tin toys. They also make really nice sand pails, which can be super popular. And this had all the like rubber and plastic tools inside the tool chest. It was a vintage Ohio art company tin Busy Boy tool chest with tools. I paid $1 for it at a yard sale, and it sold for $23.99 plus shipping. All right, so the Dunkaroo craze came. I'm not sure if the craze is necessarily still as crazy right now. I think it might be, but if I were you, I'd definitely check your sold comps and check recent to see if they're still selling. This was a pack of 12 Dunkaroos vanilla cream rainbow sprinkles, and I got these at my 7-Eleven. I paid $24 for the 12 pack, and it sold for $51.99 plus shipping. These I've had for a while. They make this Hazel Atlas like sailboat set. They can be super profitable. There's certain items that are really hard to find and can be really profitable. This one was a set of four-ounce flat tumblers. They were vintage mid-century modern Hazel Atlas ships blue with white. And those set of four glasses sold for $47.99 plus shipping. Next up was this vintage 90s NRA Millennium Member Snapback hat. It was made in the USA, which is always clutch when you're selling vintage hats. Doesn't always have to be made in the USA, but it definitely helps sometimes. This sold within minutes, and it sold for $19.99 plus shipping. Next up was this really dope vintage Nike jacket. It had the white Nike tag on the jacket, which is definitely something you want to look for when it comes to like vintage Nike. And this was a forest green tall streetwear jacket, extra large, and it sold for $50 plus shipping. Next up was this, it was huge. And the person who bought it lived in, Washington, and I live in Washington, D.C., so it was shipped all the way across the country. It was a Disney Junior Sophia the First. It was a magnetic dress up and playhouse castle, and it came with a book, and it was still sealed. The guy got it for his daughter, so I gave him a little deal on it, and it sold for $40 plus shipping. Next up was this really ugly vintage Dallas Cowboys. Nah, you know, I'm a Redskins fan, the Washington football team fan, so Cowboys are our rival. But this vintage Dallas Cowboys NFL stretch fitted hat sold for $15.99 plus shipping, and it is out the door, thankfully. These headphones I found in the side of the street in a free box. They were Sennheiser HD 205 adjustable headband headphones. I tested them. They were working. They sold for $20 plus $9 shipping. Next up was this Carnival Glass Sugar Bowl. I got this in the Dollar Glass Shed, and it sold for $20 plus shipping. I paid $1 for it, so it actually had some damage on the lid on the inside of it, but it still sold $20. I mean, I paid $1 for it, so it was a great turnaround on that item. Next up was another one of those language dictionaries. This one was a little bit more intricate, and it came with all different types of pieces with it as well. I paid $7 for this, and it sold for $124.99. It was a Ectaco Partner ER900 language teacher and talking electronic dictionary English. So yeah, those things can definitely be super profitable. Sometimes they might take a little while to sell, like these two that sold during this time frame for me. I had both of them for, you know, a couple of months, but still $7 to $125, you cannot complain about that. This was a beautiful Fenton bowl. I got this at the thrift store, and it was a vintage Fenton glass peach crest double crimped 10.5-inch bowl. I paid, I think it was $4.99 for that, and it sold for $49.99 plus shipping. Fenton glass seems to do really well on eBay. I've always sold Fenton glass. Fenton glass is one of my, you know, things that we like the most because it is one of the things my mom collected, my Dukes collected when I was growing up. So yeah, so always be on the lookout for Fenton. And we had another golf club. This was a Ping Eye 2 black dot pitching wedge with a steel shaft. It was a right-handed club. This was in the bag of clubs that I got for free, and it sold for $30 plus shipping. So that was a great sale for me. This was another item that I picked up in the dollar shed, where I went to this shed at a flea market and everything was a dollar. It was crazy. This was a vintage Davilbis perfume atomizer, yellow glass cube. It was actually really pretty. I took a best offer and it sold for $13 plus shipping. Next up was this Balik Pottery Shamrock Basket Weave Honey Jar with a gold back stamp. And this sold for $29.99 plus shipping. If you saw, I just picked up another one of these, but the one I picked up at the auction in our last video is different because it's not the basket weave. It's the honey jar with bees, shamrock, and the herringbone backdrop. And it's a little bit bigger, and that one is a lot more valuable. So I'm excited to get that one listed, hopefully today, actually. And then this was another really cool find. I got this at the flea market in Pennsylvania with Josie. This was a vintage Heron China. Always be on the lookout for Heron China. I paid like $2 to $4 for this plate. It was the Indian basket green pattern, and this was a salad plate, and it sold for $44.99 plus shipping. Next up was some more stuff from our Dale Earnhardt Vintage NASCAR haul. If you haven't seen that video, I'll try to put a link up top. This one was crazy. It was, I picked up all this vintage Dale Earnhardt stuff. And I don't know, man, I don't have much of it left, but this sweatshirt was awesome. It was a vintage 90s Dale Earnhardt crew neck sweatshirt with five-time champion. It was made in 1991, and it sold for $64.99 plus shipping. Then I had somebody buy two of my vintage Las Vegas t-shirts. So these are vintage. This one was a vintage Venetian casino single-stitch t-shirt made in the USA. Really dope. Gold, on like a turquoise sort of teal color shirt. And I took a best offer on $19 for plus shipping. I paid $2 at the thrift store. They also bought the single-stitched Las Vegas t-shirt made in the USA in pink. And they also bought that for $19 plus shipping. So that is everything that sold on eBay. Whew, man, I'm trying to catch my breath on this from July 13th to July 19th. So now we're going to show you guys a couple things that sold on Mercari. Let's do this. Mercari. Blue! So this is a vintage Fire King Jadeite. Jadeite is always going to be popping. Always keep your eye out for Jadeite. Jadeite is a huge seller. Doesn't matter what platform. Doesn't matter what it is. Obviously, you want to look out for all the reproductions and remakes because there are a ton. But this was a vintage Fire King Jadeite restaurant wear oval platter. And I got this in a lot of stuff from my old baseball football coach. And this sold for $60. And that included shipping. Next up was this GameCube game. I actually bought some GameCube games at the thrift store. And this one was stuck inside of the manual of another game. So it was basically free. I sold it with no case, just a manual in the game. It was a Nintendo GameCube Tack and the Power of Juju, and it sold for $10. Next up was this uranium glass. So when I got that free box on the side of the road, in that box was like those headphones and then a bunch of other stuff, including that teapot, that postmodern teapot that I sold for like $275. The whole reason I went to get that box was because I saw this sugar and creamer in there, and it turned out to be an amazing pickup for free. This was vintage Westmoreland glass. The name of the pattern was Woolworth Green. It was a uranium glass sugar and creamer. And the buyer was all in for $55 on that. So those are the two things that sold on Mercari. Mercari is just like in these waves. And you'll see that like in these what sold videos from, you know, this one all the way until we catch up till now in August. It's just been a roller coaster. And I mean, that's part of reselling. It's always going to be a roller coaster. So that was just part of it. And now we're going to go ahead and jump into Etsy. All right. It's time to go over Etsy. All right. So let's pop through some Etsy orders for you guys. Some really cool uranium glass in this in these sales. So this was a vintage Art Deco house glass, jade slag agate Vaseline glass ashtray. It actually had two holes in the back of it where a metal figurine would have sat in, but it was still a really cool piece, as you can see in the pictures. You know, if you guys don't know, we are huge on uranium glass, Vaseline glass, anything that glows, we love it. So always keep your eye out for this sort of green and custard looking slag, because a lot of times it will glow. So make sure you guys flash your black flashlights on items like that. So this one was sold for, the buyer was all in for $41.14. It was a beaut. This is another really awesome piece. This is a vintage Blanco amethyst glass double spout pitcher. They made these in a whole bunch of different colors. A couple of other glass companies made them as well. This one actually had the Blanco sticker on it, so that was pretty awesome. The amethyst one is beautiful. Like, I can only imagine what this looks like sitting in somebody's window. And the buyer was all in on that for $64.46. Next up, we have some more Vaseline glass. This was a really cool vintage Boyd glass hobo shoe Vaseline glass toothpick holder. And the buyer was all in on that for $30.78. Pyrex mug. So I have a whole lot of these Pyrex mugs, and I for some reason thought it would be best to just list it as one and then let people add quantities if they want. That way, if somebody just wants one, they can get one. If somebody wants multiple, they can get multiple. Instead of trying to sell it as a lot, and then it just makes it more difficult for people to buy just one. So this was a vintage Pyrex. The color was steel blue. It was a D-handled coffee mug, and the buyer was all in for $13.85. Next up was this really rad mid-century modern George's Briard signed gold flowers 8-inch bowl. I'm assuming it was, I mean, it could have been a serving bowl. It could have been part of a chip and dip set. It could have been a lot of different things. But George's Briard is one of those mid-century modern names that you want to look out for, as well as Culver. And the other one is like Fred Press, I think it is. Those are like your really popular mid-century modern barware names that will be great for you to find when you're outsourcing. And you can see this person left us great feedback, packed carefully and came in excellent condition. I love it. It was far shipping, so the buyer was all in for $56.39. Next up is more Jasperware. The Jasperware just continues to sell. It is one of the hottest selling items right now, especially the different colored Jasperware, but just keep your eye out for the Jasperware because it is on fire. I keep trying to tell you, it is on fire, en fuego. So this vintage Wedgwood pink Jasperware Aurora was the motif, and it was had no band around it, so it's just that flat look around the edge. It was a 4-inch round tray, and the buyer was all in for $40.03. Next up was a Hallmark ornament. This thing has been around for forever, so I'm glad to see it go. And the person was super happy about it, exactly as described. Packed so securely. Great seller. Will buy from again. Thank you. No, thank you. And this Hallmark keepsake ormond, a Mouse to Sheer Christmas special edition 4-piece set with box, $19.95, sold for all in buyer $25.07. It was kind of cute though. Next up was more Liberty Blue. Liberty Blue is doing really well also. This was a gravy boat from the Liberty Blue series. And the buyer was all in on that gravy boat for $35.50. If you guys haven't seen, I made a video on this Fiat on how to clean black marks off of vintage kitchenware, and it was all because this set sold a vintage trio of Homer Laughlin Fiesta Ware bowls. The marking on it was post 1986, which is always important to put in your descriptions and let people know, because people will get really upset if you don't. This one, these three bowls sold for, the buyer was all in for $31.33. This is another item that has been around for a very long time. This is one of the first things I listed when I started selling my mom's stuff on Etsy over 2 years ago. This is a vintage Happy Holidays Barbie from 1996. And the buyer was all in on that Barbie doll for $64.04. I think I still have like four Barbie dolls left. So they move maybe once every 3-4 months. So we'll see. It's kind of crazy, the whole story behind those. This was a really awesome piece. So if you watch us, you know we love Hall China, really love mid-century modern. This was both just that gaudy, gold all over, shiny mid-century modern. It's a vintage Hall China golden glow, 1.5-quart round covered casserole. And the buyer was all in on that awesome piece for $62.66. This is another old item right here. This is a really weird item because it has always had tons and tons of like interest and likes. And every time I post it on Instagram, it's one of the more, engaged pictures I post. It was like this pewter steel sort of coaster set. It used to have a carrying handle on top of the carrying handle that was like a swing, but it was broken off. But it was a vintage 8-piece Continental hand-wrought silver look coaster set, and the buyer was all in for $30.88. Here we have some more uranium glass. I got these at the Dollar Shed. It was all 5 of these coasters, and they some of them had some flea bites on them, so I put them up for pretty cheap. They were vintage Acro child set. It was green saucers, uranium glass set of 5, and the buyer was all in for $15.66. So that is everything that's sold on Etsy. We're gonna jump into our one and only sale on Grailed. All right, so Grailed was popping for a while, but it's just like everything else. If you don't post stuff, if you don't list things, you're not gonna sell things. I don't know what the theory is behind that, but it's just how things work. And I have been slacking. I've just been working on so many different things, and I'm trying to get, you know, life happens too. So it's just like trying to figure out how to balance and get work done is not easy. Anybody who told you this reselling lifestyle, this reselling game, it was easy, they're a liar. But we do it because we love it, and we do it because I do it full time because I don't have to work for the man, you know? And I don't mind the hard work, but sometimes you gotta, you know, push yourself a little bit more. Anyways, I did make one sale on Grailed from the 13th to the 19th. It was this vintage snapback trucker hat. It was a 90s Branson, I think Branson, Missouri. It was all over, dope graphic. It was like a cream color too. This was a really cool hat. As you can see, a lot of people liked it. It had 28 likes on it, and it sold for $20. So now we're gonna go ahead and jump into Poshmark. Poshmark has actually not been too bad, you know, a couple more sales here and there. This was a really cool jacket. I picked this up at the flea market in Pennsylvania with Josie. This was a vintage 90s color block Wrangler Extreme jacket. And it was just like screamed 90s all over it. And it still had the tags on it, but it did have some like storage wear spots on the sleeve, but the buyer bought that for $30. And then we sold this really cool vintage 90s Duck's Back canvas snapback hat made in the USA, and the buyer bought that for $20. And that's going to wrap it up. So it wasn't a huge 6 days of sales, but definitely good. I can't complain. Any day that you make a sale is a good day in my book. You'll see, like I said, as we start rolling out all these What Sold videos from the last month, that it's just a roller coaster. So I'm really working on trying to get like my time schedule and figure out how to allot time to everything to make it work best. So I've just been experimenting and working on new projects. But yeah, so that's everything that's sold. And always don't forget, if you ever have any questions about anything, do not hesitate to reach out to us on Instagram. You can find us at Over the Years Collecting, at Over the Years eBay, or you could leave us comments here in the description. And don't forget to tune in on Mondays. We do a live like education class where you can send us email the email is otyislive@gmail.com. You could send us pictures of items that you need help identifying, and we would do it live for you. We do that live Monday nights from 6 to 7, and then we do a live vintage sale on Monday nights from 8 to anywhere like 9 to 10. Depends on how many items we're selling. So thank you guys, as always, for tuning in. I appreciate your support, your love, your loyalty, all of the above. Have a great weekend, and we will see you guys hopefully in a couple of days with a new video. Oh yeah, don't forget, there's some videos around my face you guys can watch. Peace.